Let's think about the burnt offering in Leviticus chapter 1. Here are verses 3 and 4, quote, "If his offering is a burnt sacrifice of the herd, let him offer a male without blemish. He shall offer it of his own free will at the door of the tabernacle of meeting before the Lord. Then he shall put his hand on the head of the burnt offering, and it will be accepted on his behalf. The first of the sweet aroma offerings, if selected from the cattle, was to be, quote, a male without blemish, which makes perfect sense if it was a picture of Christ. Thus the statement, accepted on his behalf. The killed animal was then to be skinned and the hide given to the offering priest. This could become shoes, a belt, a coat, or part of a tent, some form of covering. So with the believer today, quote, he has made us accepted in the beloved. Ephesians 1:6. When you looked at the offering priest, you would see the animal offered. When God looks at me, he sees his beloved son offered on my behalf. I am accepted in him. But how solemn to notice that the offerer himself must kill the animal. No on-call butcher for him. How this reminds us of our personal responsibility for the death of the Savior. And yet he went willingly to Calvary. Here the offering pictures the highest view of the cross. While it's true that the Lord Jesus offered himself for us, ultimately he offered himself to God. Quote, Christ, through the eternal Spirit, offered himself without spot to God. Hebrews 9:14. It was God who must be fully satisfied. And for once in all of history, a real man lived every moment, every thought and action, all for God. Thus the distinctive of this offering, quote, the priest shall burn all on the altar as a burnt sacrifice to the Lord. Leviticus 1:9. May we also seek daily to be as Christ was, all for God. In the Levitical system, the burnt offering was the highest. There were three occasions when one was offered. First was the volitional burnt offering, which we have been discussing, willingly given out of gratitude for the Lord's goodness. Then in Exodus 29, we see the continual burnt offering. Two lambs of the first year, day by day, continually. One lamb you shall offer in the morning, and the other lamb you shall offer at twilight. This shall be a continual burnt offering throughout your generations. That's Exodus 29, verses 38 to 42. It was not enough to worship God from sunrise to sunset. As our lives should be, and as Christ's life ever is, it was to be non-stop pleasure to God. Added to the lamb was, quote, 1/10 of an ephah of flour mixed with 1/4 of a hin of pressed oil and 1/4 of a hin of wine as a drink offering, Exodus 29:40. The psalmist writes that the Lord gives, quote, wine that makes glad the heart of man, oil to make his face shine, and bread which strengthens man's heart, Psalm 104:15. When we give him our all, we receive gladness from God, radiance from the Spirit, and strength for living from Christ. When we arrive at Numbers 28 and 29, we will see the role of the ceremonial burnt offering given on the high and holy festivals of the nation. And yet, as the scriptures continue to unfold the truth, we discover what we may call the spiritual burnt offering. In fact, six things better than a burnt offering. What are they? Number one, obedience. 1 Samuel 15:22 and Hebrews 9:14. Number two, humility. Psalm 51, verses 16 and 17. Three, the knowledge of God, Hosea 6:6. 4, thankfulness, Psalm 69, verses 30 to 32. 5, love for the Lord and for our neighbors, Mark 12, 32 and 33. And of course, there's number 6, the supreme sacrifice, Psalm 40, 6 to 8, and Hebrews 10, 8 and 9, Christ, the fulfillment of them all.